I could think of three ways today, but I was surprised when the third way jumped up and bit me in the butt. Maybe you have something better. How do you count by week in Excel? Moe Sadr found this old question, how to count records by month, and he says, well, this is great, but how do you do it by week? I have three different ways today. The first method is a pivot table. So we have these daily dates here. I'm going to insert pivot table, put it in an existing worksheet, maybe right there, click OK. I only have one field, so I take the date field, move it to rows, I take the date field, move it to values, and I get a count of each day. All right, now we want to roll these up to weeks. So we're going to go into group field. It starts out with a default of months. You need to unselect months and choose only days. When I choose only days, this spin button here becomes enabled where I can say number of days and roll it up to 7-day periods. Now, you need to be careful because it's going to start on the first day, which is a Saturday in this case. And if you want your week to start on Monday, let's say, you're going to want to back that up from the Saturday to the previous Monday. That would be 12/27 of the previous year. Click OK. And there we are. We have 7-day periods with the count. Another way to go is a great function called the weekday function. I'm a big fan of using this, particularly with this one here, the numbers 0 through 6. So that's argument 3. Tells me a code for the day of the week. The way that this is really useful, skip column B, take the date minus the weekday, comma 3. And when we double click to copy that down, it backs everything to the previous Monday. When a date already started on Monday, the fact that we get a 0 for the weekday makes sure that it stays on that Monday. Once you have these, the week of dates in column C, over here in column E, I use the equal sort of the unique of that range of week starting dates. That gets me a sorted list of all of the items. And then in the next column, a COUNTIF of all of this data, C4 to C892, looking at each of the items in E4 hash. Of course, E4 hash is the nomenclature to say we want to run this COUNTIF for each item in the E4 array. Now, before I move on to method 3, let's just note here that the answers for the first few weeks are 4, 11, and 9, because we're going to run into some trouble with ISOWEEKNUM of the date. This tells us which week of the year, numbered 1 to 52, although every 7 years there's a 1 to 53. When I do this sort of the unique, notice that the counts are wrong. They don't match the previous item. And that's because my data here spans 2 years. I have data both in 2022 and 2023. So I had to change this formula to add in the year of A4 &W in quotes, and then the text of ISO week number using 2 digits. That gets me something that shows me both the year and the week. The sort needs the 01, 02, 03 in order to sort this correctly. So you have 3 methods. Personally, I would go with the pivot table, but weekday or ISOWEEKNUM are alternatives. Thanks to Moe for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.